Next up, after years of debates and stalemates, it finally happened. Last month, Nebraska legislators gave approval to a bill that delivers state income tax relief in order to help offset local property taxes paid in and fine-tune the state's business incentives program. While the tax compromise provides temporary relief, it appears more structural reform is still necessary. Market Journal's Bill Dodd recently spoke with an expert to find out how this impacts property owners and what comes next in the process.
In the final days of the 2020 legislative session, the Nebraska unicameral greenlit a notable piece of property tax relief legislation. While a good deal of work remains to be done, property owners in Nebraska can claim a refundable state income tax credit during the 2021-22 fiscal year. While it was welcome news for many to hear a compromise had been reached on an issue that has hounded lawmakers for many years, a compromise nonetheless means not everyone got what they wanted in the end.
As soon as possible.
I mean, there are three major programs that were part of the ultimate compromise. The property tax relief was the one that we're talking about. There's also the state program for businesses, the economic development program that provides tax incentives to businesses or that creates more jobs in the state. And then there's a state funding to help the University of Nebraska Med Center qualify for an awful lot of federal money to develop a new pandemic response center in the Med Center. So those three things were, those three bills were based, or those three programs were put into the one proposal. And the idea was that the rural senators would not vote for the economic development program update and would not vote for the Med Center funding unless everybody agreed to support the property tax relief. And so that was the biggest part of the compromise, that everybody got what they want. Now, in terms of the what was proposed last year, there are a couple of things that were controversial. One was property tax relief was going to be funded by closing loopholes in the sales tax that we collect, like on groceries or medicine or doctor office visits or gasoline, for example. Those exemptions are over $150 million a year for each one, and collectively they're over $700 million. $700 million in new sales tax revenue would fund a lot of property tax relief. The governor said that is a no-go.
All things being equal, the debate on how best to fund property tax relief has the state's public school system caught in a funding limbo of sorts. This aspect of the argument has put rural and urban representatives at odds with one another.
There was definitely an urban versus rural dimension to this, and the reason changing the state aid formula was so controversial, it meant that urban and larger, like Grand Island, say, or Kearney or Hastings, larger communities in Nebraska, they would see probably a reduction in the money they get from the state. But the smaller school districts in the rural parts of the county and the rural parts of Nebraska, theirs would go up because, now they're getting very little. And, if they got $100 a head per pupil or something, if they got, 300 pupils, that'd be, $30,000 into their budget coming out of, somebody else's budget somewhere else, in a different part of Nebraska. So there was definitely a strong urban-rural dimension to this. And urban senators were the ones who were making the vote. It's irresponsible to do that, making the argument, it's irresponsible to do this because, if we need to spend money to deal with the COVID crisis or something like that, this is going to tie our hands. This is not the time to be starting a program like this. And, hopefully that won't come about, but we'll see what the next few months are like.
While this legislation is still in its infancy, property owners can expect in the short term to receive about a 6% refundable state income tax credit of property taxes paid to local schools, with that amount presumably increasing in the years to come.
It would, this year is estimated to be about a 6% reduction in property taxes paid. In 5 years, that amount, the amount of the state money available for these income tax credits would triple. So other things being equal, you know, that could be an 18% reduction in property taxes paid. So, I mean, these are, you know, ballpark figures, but that gives some idea. So they're hoping that if this goes the way it's supposed to and there's enough money, the state has enough money to pay the tax credits and stuff like that, that it could be a very significant property tax reduction down the road. And this is kind of the first installment.
One thing is certain, whether it be closing sales tax loopholes or limiting school spending, unless an alternative form of revenue can be agreed upon to generate additional property tax relief, we're going to have to wait and see if our current economic conditions will create tax revenue abundant enough to fully fund property tax relief in the years to come. Reporting for Market Journal, I'm Bill Dodd.